What is the genetic history of Switzerland, and what haplogroups are common among Swiss people today? Now, four official languages are spoken in Switzerland today, with German the most common, followed by French, Italian, and Romansh. As you can see in this map, the country is bordered by Italy to the south, France to the west, Germany to the north, and Austria and Liechtenstein to the east. Switzerland, officially known as the Swiss Confederation, originates from the Old Swiss Confederacy established in the late Middle Ages, following a series of military successes against Austria and Burgundy. The Federal Charter of 1291 is considered the country's founding document, with Swiss independence from the Holy Roman Empire formally recognised in the Peace of Westphalia in 1648. The modern federal state of Switzerland was established with the adoption of the Swiss Federal Constitution in 1848, however. An interesting point to note is that Switzerland has maintained a policy of armed neutrality since the 16th century and has not fought in an international war since 1815. But what about the genetic history of Switzerland? Well, a really interesting study was published in 2020 that looked at the ancient genetics of Switzerland during the late Neolithic period. It analysed 96 ancient genomes from Switzerland, southern Germany, and the Alsace region of France, covering the middle-late Neolithic period to the early Bronze Age. One of the central findings was that there was an arrival of ancestry related to late Neolithic pastoralists from the Pontic-Caspian Steppe in Switzerland as early as 2860 to 2460 BC. They added that this analysis suggests that this genetic turnover was a complex process lasting almost 1,000 years. As far as haplogroups around this time, they found a range of different mitochondrial haplogroups from these 96 ancient genomes, namely N1A, WXH, T2Gi, different variations of U, as well as K. On the Y-DNA side, it's really interesting to see the changes in the Y-DNA haplogroups between older and younger samples analysed in the study. As the supplementary information of the study notes, in individuals older than 2600 BC, they almost exclusively belonged to the Y-DNA haplogroups I2A and G2A. After 2200 BC, however, all individuals carried R1B, besides one, which belonged to R1A. The most common branch of R1B these ancient individuals belonged to was L2, also known as S139, which is thought to have originated around the Alps or the southern Rhine region, splitting off from R1B U152 relatively early on. So Switzerland saw this arrival of steppe ancestry during the Bronze Age, and this is in line with various other parts of Europe. This steppe ancestry that came into Switzerland mixed with the two previous ancestral sources in Switzerland at that time. Firstly, you had Western hunter-gatherers, and then you had early European farmers from around Anatolia originally. But what about later episodes in the genetic history of Switzerland? Well, first up, let's look at the Celtic groups, as during the Iron Age, Switzerland was home to various Celtic tribes, and one in particular, known as the Helvetti. The Celts brought their unique culture, language, and artistic styles, and this period also helped contribute to the genetic diversity we see in Switzerland today. An interesting study from earlier this year, published in Nature Human Behaviour, looked at the early Iron Age in France, Germany, and Switzerland, known as the West Hallstatt Kreis. This was during a time when the Hallstatt culture flourished in Europe, a culture often referred to as Early Celtic, and which was followed by the Latin culture, very much associated with the ancient Celts. This study analysed 31 individuals from this context in southern Germany, dating between 616 and 200 BC. They found that the Y-DNA haplogroups of these people were dominated by R1B M269 and G2A P303, reflecting this earlier mixing of both steppe ancestry and ancestry from the previous peoples of Europe, as we saw earlier. This study, however, found two really interesting further inflows during this time. Firstly, there was an inflow of ancestry from southern Europe during this period. Secondly, there was also movements of people from northern Europe, and this was probably connected to the Cimbri and the Teutones, as the study noted. Genetic outliers from this and previously published studies suggest that, subsequently, at the height of the Celtic migrations during the 4th and 3rd century BC, not only Celts migrated, but at least a limited number of people from northern Central Europe reached the southern zone of the Latin culture and even northern Italy, possibly associated with historical entities like the Cimbri and Teutones. The homeland of these tribes of the Cimbri and the Teutones are both originally thought to have been in the Jutland Peninsula in modern-day Denmark, before they migrated south and eventually went on to fight the Cimbrian War against the Roman Republic. Now look at this photo. This is the amphitheatre of Aventicum, which was the largest town and capital of Roman Switzerland. The arena was used for gladiatorial events, animal hunts, and other forms of entertainment in Roman times. This photo speaks to another change in the genetics of ancient Switzerland, the Roman period. A major early event in this was when Julius Caesar defeated the Helvetti in the Gallic Wars of 58 BC. The area of modern Switzerland was absorbed by the Romans over the years, and remained under Roman influence for centuries until the 5th century AD. What genetic impact did the Romans have in Switzerland then? Well, they introduced, or during this time, there was an introduction of Mediterranean ancestry, although relatively small but still notable, with haplogroups, Y-DNA haplogroups like E1B1B and Gi2 becoming more common amongst the population, as the Roman period marked an increase of movement around the Mediterranean zone. The Western Roman Empire collapsed in the 5th century AD, however, and this period saw another major change in Europe and the genetics of Switzerland. These migrations were of course mainly led by Germanic peoples, who spread across large parts of Europe during the migration period. This brought more Germanic and Nordic ancestry into Switzerland, with haplogroups such as R1b, U106 and I1 becoming more common amongst the population. Two Germanic people are important to note when it comes to Switzerland. The first was the Alemanni, who settled in northern and eastern Switzerland. And the second was the Burgundians, who occupied the western part. In 496, however, the Alemanni were conquered by the Frankish leader Clovis, with the Franks also incorporating the Kingdom of Burgundy into the Frankish Kingdom in 534 AD. So the Franks controlled the land we call Switzerland for a period, and we know that the Franks' Y-DNA haplogroups were dominated by R1b, U106. If we look at this map of R1b, U106, which is also known as S21, we can see it's highest in Northern Europe today still, and in parts of North and Northwest Switzerland. Switzerland would later become part of the Holy Roman Empire for centuries, an empire that grew out of the Franks to a large degree. Over the centuries as well, there has obviously been lots of movement from neighbouring countries into Switzerland, with significant migration from Italy in the late 19th and early 20th century, for example. But what about the genetics of modern Switzerland, and what haplogroups are common among Swiss people today? Well, a really interesting study was published in 2020 in Forensic Science International, Genetics, that analysed the Y chromosomal haplotype and the haplogroup distribution of modern Switzerland. They analysed 606 Swiss men from across the country. 435 individuals were German-speaking, 118 were French-speaking, and 51 were Italian-speaking. One person reported both Italian and German as mother tongues, and one person's mother tongue was Romansh. One important point this study found was that the Alps has and still serves as a natural barrier for human migration. I should note as well that the communities that have lived in the Alpine region for ages, for centuries, are usually more genetically isolated than the rest of the population. This study mainly looked at the Alps as a natural barrier though, and the authors found that the genetics of the Swiss population to the north of the Alps is slightly different to the people living in the south. In Ticino, for example, the southernmost canton of Switzerland that straddles the Italian border. As the study noted, we detected five significant regional differences in haplogroup spread, whereas the haplogroups I1, M253 and R1b, U106 are more or less evenly distributed north of the Alps, they are almost absent from the Ticino sample. In return, haplogroups Gi2a, M410 and R1b, U152 are far more abundant in the Ticino sample than in the rest of the country. Furthermore, we detected a significant enrichment of haplogroup E1b1b, M35 in the easternmost sample from St. Gallen. So in general, R1b is the most common Y-DNA haplogroup in Switzerland today, but the different branches of this haplogroup speak to the different peoples and migrations down through history. The two sublineages of R1B in particular are R1B U106 and R1B U152, with the latter the most common in the country. In general, R1B U106 is associated more with Germanic peoples and ancestry down through history. And again, if we look at this map of its distribution today, we can see how common it is in Northern Europe. R1B U152, on the other hand, is more of a Italo-Celtic branch, and you can see in this map, it peaks in places like northern Italy today. The study notes that this R1B U152 haplogroup fits well with the ancient Celtic people known as the Laponti, who lived in parts of modern Switzerland and northern Italy around the Alps. As the study notes, this local present-day hotspot for haplogroup R1B U152 fits quite well the ancient habitats of Celtic cultures such as the Laponti, being most probably at the origin of the name Valle Leventina, for the upper part of the Ticino Valley. Haplogroup R1B U152 is significantly less frequent north of the Alps, but remains the most frequent haplogroup throughout the entire country. So we could say that Switzerland north of the Alps has more Germanic markers, whereas Switzerland south of the Alps has more Celtic markers, which is quite interesting. Now, this is the linguistic map of the country, with French spoken more in the west, for example. What is interesting is this 2020 study looked at the relationship between genetic profiles and the languages spoken in different parts of Switzerland, and they actually found a few quite surprising nuances. In the Italian-speaking subsample, for instance, the people are genetically closer to samples from Spain rather than Italy, as the study noted. If we divide the sample into language subgroups, the German-speaking subpopulation locates even closer to the Austrian sample, whereas the French-speaking subpopulation is somewhat closer to the samples from Belgium and Spain. Surprisingly, the Italian-speaking sample co-localizes with the sample from Spain and is significantly different from the Italian sample. Why is the Italian-speaking region closer to Spain than Italy, though? Well, the study adds that the fact that the Italian-speaking subsample co-locates rather with the sample from Spain than with the sample from Italy might be attributed to the higher overall percentage of haplogroup R1B in Spain than in Italy. The fraction of R1B in the Spanish population corresponds better to the 70% R1B in the Ticino sample. So on the Y-DNA side at least, which is only one way to look at the genetics of a country, I should note, the Italian-speaking Swiss region is closer to Spain than Italy. Overall, this study found that the Swiss population was genetically closest to Western Europeans in general. So to summarise the Y-DNA haplogroups, R1B is the most common, followed by I, both I1, which is associated more with Germanic people and Nordic ancestry, and I2, an ancient haplogroup of Europe, then E1B1B, G, Jai, and R1A. What about the maternal side though? Well, H is the most common mitochondrial haplogroup in Switzerland, similar to Western Europe, Central Europe, as well as Scandinavia. H is believed to have originated in the Near East around 25,000 years ago, and its movement into Europe seems to have been through various waves, with the early European farmers helping to increase this haplogroup's frequency when they spread across Europe. Other mitochondrial haplogroups found in Switzerland include variations of U, such as U5, one of the oldest lineages in Europe. Smaller levels of mitochondrial haplogroups, T, J, and K, are among the other maternal markers found in the country. So Switzerland has had various influences on it down through history, but Germanic ancestry is a key component. Speaking of Germanic ancestry though, what was the genetics of Germanic peoples down through history, and what did these peoples look like? What was their hair colour, what was their eye colour, etc? To find out, please click here. Thanks for watching, please subscribe and hit the bell. If you would like to vote for what video topics I make videos on, I will put a link to my Patreon page below, and that will also help support my work in general. But yeah, thanks again for watching, please let me know your thoughts below, and I'll see you next time.